Hello, my name is Yogini Rasa and I'm certified open yoga teacher. It is very happy to see you all again, and we are continuing with our topics for the yoga site yogaopenyoga.com, where everybody can learn yoga from very basics. As we are here today and talking about the kinds of yoga, then today's topic is going to be Kriya Yoga. Probably most of you have never heard this word and don't even know what I'm talking about. Very good kind of yoga, one of the classical kinds of yoga, and has a lot of to do with the Hatha Yoga and the physical body. At least it looks so from the outside, as many poses really remind of Hatha Yoga. And it is physical, it is, it has a certain rhythm, and still it is not really regarded as the one working that much with the physical body rather than with our fine body or the group of the fine bodies. What can we say? It's dynamical yoga, and as I said, it has the rhythm. We are not giving the rhythm that we need to do the exercises, but we need to find the rhythm. So everybody needs movements. Try to stay in one position, standing or laying down, and not to move. Can you do it a minute or two or three or five? If the person is not having movements for an hour, it is a great discomfort. Thereby, imagine how our body actually feels when we give it a minimum or almost no movements during a day. Either we sit, take one standing or sitting position like this or like that, but the body needs to move. This is like a food for the body. We give the food the food products, and also the food for the body is movements. Thereby, again, it's not like when we move, don't move at all or move too much, where we receive the best result with the most of the movements, but we need to find this balanced number, balanced rhythm of the movements that our body at this moment needs. If we don't move, we will get sick. If we move too much, we will get hurt, but injured, and get other problems, and again, it's not going to work well. Thereby, we have Kriya Yoga that helps us to find this rhythm at that time on the yoga mat, but in our everyday life, we again find this rhythm for other activities. What do we have? We have the certain sequence of movements. We have certain movements and certain sequence of movements, like we have an alphabet. There are certain letters and different languages, different letters. And the same with Kriya Yoga. And we are supposed to learn them in a certain order and to do them. When we know the alphabet, we can form the words, we can form the sentences. We can change the order, but most of the people stay through the order that is suggested by the ancient yogis. Actually, ancient yogis developed this method, as the myths are telling us, when they were meditating, sitting in one position for a very long time, like we do today, and gradually coming to kind of working specific parts of the body, a lot of working with the back muscles, with the abdomen muscle that are required. Actually, all the muscles are moved in required amount, and very good practice. So, and this is what we are working with the physical body when we get on the mat. In the beginning, we try to remember the sequence. When we have remembered, actually, it's the body that remembers, we can work with our thoughts. And after some time, we get in the state of meditation. That is dynamic meditation. One more word for this kind of yoga is dynamic meditation. And it works very well when practiced in a balanced, harmonious way. Because a lot of beginners, like they, when they start doing Hatha yoga, they try to exceed the time they spend in a pose or the time of the class. The same happens in Kriya, even if you have the specific time for each pose, people try to do it faster, harder, stronger. And again, it's a fast access to the failure, unfortunately. But when person kind of finds this balanced way, it gives many positive emotions. One more thing about unpleasant emotions. If we start speeding or do some other things that we shouldn't, probably there is a pose that they are all quite simple. Only the introductory kriyas or poses are a bit more challenging for the beginners. We need kind of find what we will do in this pose, or if there are some problems that hurt or feel unwell, not due to the lack of movement but due to other things, we need to find the more balanced and better way to do the pose. Or we just omit the pose and spend some time in a still position or variation. More, of course, about the Kriya Yoga, this is only the insight, will be on the specific yoga course as well as in the master classes. But yes, if you have any unpleasant emotions, you stop or you slow down. And you keep observing. That's the thing that matters. You don't expect somebody like the yoga instructor that is very recommended in the very beginning, but you observe yourself and you make decisions for yourself. It's good to have the yoga instructor. If you don't have a yoga instructor and you don't read the ancient texts or you don't have them at your side, then Open Yoga has developed a nice video material for doing Kriya Yoga, where you can compare or see how other people are doing it. They are all in the same classroom, they all are different, they are of different age, different genders, different backgrounds, and they are practicing Kriya Yoga. All of them are benefiting from it, and still this can look doing the same thing from one aspect, but still looking so different from the other aspect. You can find the video in our Kriya Yoga course as well as on our YouTube channel, or if you have any problems in finding it, you can contact us. So yes, that's what you are oriented, that's your pointer, the joy. You enjoy it, you like it. Of course, there can be some effort required, especially in the very beginning. Sometimes you will need to take a break from this kind of yoga, just to kind of, you will have done something. And foresee this as uncoding yourself. You are like the treasure that is behind the code, and you need to find the access to this treasure inside you. You knew the code, you forgot it, or for some reason you made yourself to forget it, and thereby work with it. Use the sequence of Kriya Yoga as your code. Code opener or encrypting of the code, and also use the Kriya Yoga as the kind of for making your practice more interesting, because doing only Hatha Yoga can get a bit boring from time to time. Shouldn't, but could. You can try other kinds of yoga like Kriya Yoga. And with the time, it will form a very good foundation for other kinds of yoga that you are going to practice. Because in order to start working with the meditation and probably with some breathing exercises, you need to get your body at the certain state of the power and strength that the Kriya Yoga and Hatha Yoga are very nicely doing together. And I know a lot of successful yogis who did not find Hatha Yoga suitable for their physical condition or their understanding of their state of being. They started with the Kriya Yoga and gradually went to Hatha Yoga and then to other kinds of yoga, and still they are still practicing the same sequence over and over for many, many years and discovering this kind of yoga in more detail. So please review the text of this class on the site yogaopenyoga.com. Pass the test to have the access to the next class, and next time we'll probably talk on mantra yoga.